Deputy O'Quinn.
Minister, at the outset, I think your reference to the Moriarty Tribunal is hardly an appropriate analogy. Minister, people across Ireland, and no doubt by now across the world, have been moved by the calm, dignified, but yet powerful testimony on the primetime programme last night of Pravin Halappanavar. And he told us directly of the terrible ordeal that his wife, Savita had been subjected to, an ordeal, make no mistake about it, that no other woman should ever have to face on these shores. And yet, despite all that he has been through, he still told us that he loved Ireland. But above all, he made it very, very clear to all watching, to all listening, that he and his family have no confidence in a HSE inquiry. We need to listen to what he has told us. We need to be very, very clear about this. Can I ask the Minister, what efforts have been employed by the Minister for Health or his department, by the HSE, by an Taoiseach, to make direct contact with Pravin Halappanavar prior to the announcement of the inquiry, or indeed since? I was in attendance at the Health and Children Committee meeting on Tuesday when the Director Designate of the HSE, Tony O'Brien, indicated and appealing to the media there present at the meeting to use their good offices to inform Mr. Halappanavar that he would welcome contact from him. Now, I have to say, you know, this is totally inappropriate, and yesterday the Taoiseach used the opportunity here as well of this Dáil chamber to communicate with Pravin and his family. I'd like to know if any serious efforts have been employed, if any offer has been extended for an Taoiseach to meet directly with Pravin Halappanavar, as I believe should now happen, and as I have already urged this morning in the course of Morning Ireland's attention to this issue. Can I ask, will this effort now be undertaken by government? Will an Taoiseach make that direct approach to Mr. Halappanavar and sit down with him to address the issues concerned? And will the government accept that we are in an impossible situation here if this inquiry is to have any credibility, if it is to be able to carry out its function? And part of its function must be to restore public confidence and, above all, confidence in the women of Ireland. I urge that a full, independent inquiry be undertaken.
Thank you. Minister.
Just again to say that there are two important issues here. Whatever comfort and support this state and the government can offer to Mr. Halappanavar and his family, and his dignity, his willingness to speak despite his appalling grief, and the way he expressed himself, his courteous references to Ireland, to Irish institutions, I think he is to be commended for all of that. He appears to be a deeply courteous man. In fairness, when the news of this was first broadcast in the media, there was an expression that communication was to be via his legal advisor. And in fact, his legal advisor has, I think, done a number of interviews setting out the position in relation to his client. I can assure you that every effort will be made and every appropriate response will be made by the government in respect to any way in which Mr. Halappanavar and his family can be supported. But I want to say, Deputy, and I think you would agree, that when a death occurs in a hospital which requires investigation and inquiry, the reason that that happens is from a health and safety point of view, to ensure that no unsafe practices have occurred which would put further patients at risk. That's the general approach in this matter. Taking into account the sensitivities of the matter, not just for the family of the bereaved and the husband of the bereaved, but for, I think, so many people in this country, particularly women. The government appointed an internationally renowned expert and a panel of experts. We also have the statement by the former and much renowned Master of Holles Street, Dr. Boylan, supporting an inquiry which would be held expeditiously and quickly. And my understanding is that the ambition in relation to the inquiry which is underway is that it would be completed on a preliminary basis before Christmas. I think, Deputy, that I would exercise caution at this point in going into a longer vista. There are provisions for ministerial inquiries. It's happened under previous governments. It's happened already under this government. But in relation to the health and safety aspect of the management of hospitals, it's my sincere view that you need to find out quite quickly in order to ensure that there is no endangerment to any woman or their child in relation to practices in our maternity hospitals. That does not, by the way, preclude further detailed inquiries. But I have to say myself, in terms of hospital incidents, establishing the facts, establishing health and safety considerations as quickly as possible are paramount. But in addition to seeking to do that, Thank you. Government has appointed very renowned independent experts to actually carry out this particular inquiry as expeditiously as possible. It does not rule out anything else.
Remember, Minister,
the issue here is why did a healthy young woman who was unfortunately miscarrying an early term baby, she went into hospital. All of the indications from what we read in the media are that she was miscarrying and medicine could not stop the miscarriage. That seems to be the indications. And of course, in Irish hospitals, the staff would move to, if possible, prevent the miscarriage so the baby could be carried successfully to term. The normal practice, as I would understand it, most women would understand,
Thank you, Minister.
Is that at a certain point there would be a D&C. And the woman would, and in fact, the reason for that, by the way,
Minister, you're way
would be
over
that
time,
the family
would, you please cooperate
would
with the chair.
Be able
Thank
to
you.
Go on to have further children. Now, it is important from a health and safety point of view that we have an answer as expeditiously as possible as to what happened so that women are not further endangered in any way, that we get an explanation. The women of Ireland, as well as the Halapanavar family, are owed that explanation. And that check on safety as quickly as possible.
Deputy O'Carroll, well, you 1 minute, Deputy. Thank you.
Minister, how can you stand up here this morning and claim that it was your intention and is your intention to act expeditiously? That holds no water. The fact of the matter is, but that Pravin Halapanavar had actually taken the decision some 2 weeks after this terrible tragedy to go public, and because no efforts were being employed by the HSE or the authorities in relation to the tragic death of his wife. We have to say that it is reasonable for people to question whether any kind of serious inquiry would ever have been undertaken but for the fact that Mr. Halapanavar had gone public with this terrible, terrible story that he has had to share with us. And that is an indictment of the system, of the HSE,
Question,
of the
please.
Department and of this government. And I want to say to you, make no mistake about it, there is no possible credibility for the inquiry currently constituted, and that is not to question the capacity, the suitability or otherwise of those now named to participate.
We have a question,
it is
please.
To recognise that without Pravin Halappanavar's cooperation and perhaps approval for access to all of the critical file notes in relation to his wife's tragic experience, that this particular
inquiry will have no future.
I'm asking you, Minister, will you, A, as I'd asked you earlier, use your good offices to impact with Taoiseach, that he will appreciate the importance of direct contact with Mr. Halappanavar, that that is essential now, no matter what is to happen subsequently.
Thank you.
And that there is undoubtedly a huge demand, and it's not confined
to the
voices of opposition.
Sorry, would you please ask a question? You're way over
for
time.
A public.
Thank you.
Well, I don't have that hand, Count Corlett, that the Minister was able to employ several times a moment ago. I want to finish my sentence. Will you take on board the demands also of opposition and government voices for a full independent inquiry into this terrible, terrible event? And that is in the interest only of truth and justice.
1 minute to reply. Thank you.
Thank you. Just to say to the Deputy, that I don't think the tone, the adversarial tone, is appropriate. I have doubts, Deputy, that your suggestions that this would be a full independent commission of inquiry with a heavy input of lawyers on all sides is exactly what this country needs at this point. I would remind you that when Judge Moriarty entered in good faith into his inquiry, he said it would happen within 12 months. Now, just let me say that the government has moved. The important issue here is women's health. It's not politics, it's women's health. And I hope that you will accept that I and other women have a direct interest in this, and that I say what I say out of personal conviction, that there are young women going into hospital today, this week and next week, and I want to know that they are safe and what has happened will not happen again. Well, can I just suggest that while you are interested, Deputy, and I acknowledge this, first of all, Mr. Halappanavar took the very brave decision to go public. It is as a consequence of him going public that we know what we now know, and he is to be congratulated for doing that.
Thank you, Minister.
But what we have to do is to find out as quickly as possible, are there procedures in that hospital that in any way endanger the life and the health of women? We need to know that. And we need that, I would put it to you, Deputy, as expeditiously as possible for the women of Ireland.
Thank you.